had the opening, earned it. The wide forehand of Shushin is going to be one possible place. Mainly not because he's Shushin necessarily, but because it's doubles. And he's got a teammate, a right-hander on the other side. But if he's confident like this with the backhand, he's going to be very tough to play. It keeps him in position to cover the wide forehand. A soft flick from Shushin, continuing the streak here. Now, one thing that was tough for Lin Wenru against Shushin was receiving serve, getting his backhand in over the table. Teaching will be receiving here. Liu Shuan with the forehand flick. Stepping around. This is actually a signature shot for Shushin as well. Coming around the backhand corner for that forehand flick.
Left. Five ball.
Oh, and just when you thought she was going to have a taste of her own medicine, Liu Shuwen is there, chases it down, and plays it down the line. She didn't even leave early, waited right till the point of contact. So quick, she doesn't have a lot of wingspan. But she makes up for it with leg strength, speed in the feet. Deep push to try and give Lin Wenru a chance. I keep wanting to say Toby. That's what his parents call him, his English name, the silent assassin. A little help from the top of the net. The inside the table backhand gets on the scoreboard for the Taiwanese two. On the move, Shushin finds the short side of the table from way behind. Both Liu Shuwen and Shushin keeping this alive for a while. Short stroke there from Lin Wenru, but the big stroke, the forehand, the long swing that we've seen time and time again from Shushin comes through to win the point.
2-8.
Second point here. A little bit of fuel, but a long way to go. Off the top of the net once again, the counter coming through. Lin Wenru, his backhand strong. When he's closer to the table, even more effective. Nice. For the second time, we've seen the topspin cause trouble on the wide forehand of Chung Yijing. But it's not just her, other men around the world having trouble calibrating to Shushin's spin game. So much wrist activity. That penhold grip really adds to the flexibility factor. Once again, heavy topspin. Shushin setting up 7 game points for him and Liu Shuwen. And the flick attempted, but it finds the net. 11-3, world number one pairing, Shushin and Liu Shuwen. Could come down. It does come down, as gravity still works, but not on the table here. Just the reactions from the other side for a moment. Good counter loop here from Lin Wenru behind the table. Down low near the ground, not so many people able to do what Shushin does and scoop that ball up.
Two. Left. One more.
Perfect placement from Liu Shiwen, finds the open forehand corner. Come out in front, a bit of a punching stroke. Chop block attempted from Lin Wenru. It's always tough, I'd say, one to even control Xu Xin's shot. But to make a chop block from behind the table that's effective, even if it comes down. Liu Shiwen showing how strong she can be. Again, the Chiquita that many of the top men in the world have trouble keeping in place. She plays back on the parallel. Out to the wide forehand of Zheng Yijing. Good movement to get in for the forehand flick kill. Now, one thing that many admire about Lin Wenru's game is how smooth he is, how effortless he makes it seem. Not the biggest guy in the world, on the thinner side for sure, but a good steady base, wide stance. That hooking shot from Xu Xin bends right across the body, Lin Wenru. And even recovering the net, Liu Shiwen not phased. It was trouble earlier on in game number one, several points. With that low, scraping the net backhand from Lin Wenru. Xu Xin had a bit of trouble, but Liu Shiwen so far, no problems.
3-6.
Short side of the table, nearly catches Xu Xin with the behind the back shot. Good placement here from Yijing to the short side. Strong flick, but Lin Wenru right there with the racket face open. Guides it back. Keeps the racket high in case of emergency, which there was. And he was prepared. So if I remember correctly, 3 points in a row now for the Taiwanese two.
Left, 6-5. Left, 6-5.
Find ways to get in closer to the table. This camera angle actually helps us gain perspective from the other angle. One, with Liu Shiwen so close to the table, but two, just the fact that we're close, or closer to Liu Shiwen and Xu Xin's side, changes the perspective. Timeout now. Back from the timeout, down by two. And less spin imparted here, just the racket up high, closing on the ball. It's a 3-point lead now for world number ones, the Cloud Walker and the world champion. Inside out, finally a shot that Lucian can't reach. If she can reach it, it seems that she can control it. That's been the trend so far. From early on in that rally, still spins it deep on the table. Look how much arc on Shuxin's shot. While dips and dives, gives a little bit of time to Lin Wenru. Step around and play the inside out forehand.
Left, 8-6.
Positive play here, Lin Wenru getting in over the table, trying to find the wide angles. Again, the wide forehand for Liu Shiwen has been an answer for a little bit. Hasn't been easy to find it. Again, she glides, she floats behind the table. By behind the table, I mean just barely behind the table.
8-0.
Back edge here.
Nine,
I Ching,
eight.
The clipping shot. So the Taiwanese two up by one. Quite clear to see even from that angle in the replay. The angle here moves in, steps around the corner, and with the arm dragging behind, plays it wide to the forehand side. Two game points for the Taiwanese two. Game point saved, one more to go. Second serve here for Liu Shiwen. We've seen heavy underspin effective before. See what Shuxin called for in a moment. Shovel serve sets up the third ball attack. Shuxin stepping around. Two game points saved by world number ones. Mostly side, just a little bit of topspin to earn the height. Not a lot of height. You can see how far out Shuxin has to reach to get that shot. And going low, sweeping the leg, Shuxin recovers a net to do this shot. The rhythm already broken. You're behind the table. At least you have a little time to react, but it shortens it up. And he still makes the shot touching ground, and it's a clear winner. Game point now for Shuxin and Liu Shiwen. This time a little bit more off the net. Shuxin not able to recover it. So game point recovered after a 3-point streak for the Chinese pair. Shuxin making an outstanding receive. Lin Wenru apologizing quickly for not either making it long enough or short enough. Whatever it was, it gave the opening attack to Liu Shiwen. And here is the timeout for the Chinese side, Shuxin and Liu Shiwen. And the parallel backhand does it, a 2-0 lead, Shuxin and Liu Shiwen. Back for game number three, Liu Shuwen and Xu Xin leading 2-0, 1 game away from the final. The backhand of Xu Xin. It's the backhand that showed up 2019 with the most consistency we've seen from Xu Xin's backhand in his career. Xin is off balance. It makes it even tougher to anticipate exactly what's on his ball. You've got side spin, you've got top spin, but how much of each? Timeouts on either side now. Coach is allowed to coach in between points ever since October 1st of 2016. Silently asking for a new ball. As the silent assassin would. By the way, his English is amazing. And amazingly quiet. Once again, Liu Shuwen recovering a net. Scoreline right now makes me want to check to see who Liu Shuwen and Xu Xin would be facing in the final.
Love six.
Now all the conversation has been about Jun Mizutani and Mima Ito. And sure enough, it's Jun Mizutani and Mima Ito already waiting in the final. 3-0 victory for them, spoiler alert. Mid-distance over Wang Chunting and Du Hoi Kem. If you saw Wang Chunting yesterday, probably wouldn't surprise you that much. Definitely needing a break to recover. Not a point dropped yet for Xu Xin and Liu Shuwen. Good side spin on that ball from under the table. Zheng Yiqing just guiding it back, putting a bit of hook on it to make the ball kick.
Flat 8-1.
Xu Xin doing what he does best, spinning the ball from half long. I don't know if I'd say best. One of the many things that he does better than most. Solid receive as well, right off the bounce. It is 9 match points for a 3-0 victory to join the Japanese pair. And the perfect touch, Xu Xin and Liu Shuwen take it in form. 11-1 in game number 3, dominating games 1 and 3, a tight one in game.